안녕하세요, 여러분. 저는 호프리스입니다. 오늘은 한국 인도 퓨전 음식 만들겠습니다. 한국 전통 반찬은 잡채랑 파르시 음식 다모다바이도 만들겠습니다.
We'll start off by marinating the meat. I have used chicken here, but you can use any meat of your choice.
Now I'm going to let this sit in the refrigerator for some time. In the meantime, let's prepare the vegetables for the stir fry.
First, boil the spinach, drain out the water and chop it into chunks. Now we'll chop up some onions, leeks, carrots, mushrooms and red bell pepper. Cut all these into 2-inch large pieces and keep them separate from each other. In noodles, you can either use glass noodles or cellophane noodles, but I did not find any, so I'm using rice vermicelli as an alternative. Add 1 teaspoon of sesame oil, 2 teaspoons of soy sauce and 1/2 teaspoon brown sugar. Mix it well. Let's stir fry our veggies. Grease a pan with oil and add the onions and leeks to it. Wait till the onions become translucent. Then transfer them to the bowl. Now mushrooms. Stir fry the mushrooms till they become light brown and juicy. Add them to the dish as well. Lastly, we'll fry the carrots and the bell pepper. Add the carrots first, and once they change color, add the bell pepper.
Wow, it looks so red. Reminds me of Christmas, which is coming soon.
집중해.
Oops, sorry. Let's get back to work.
Once it's done, transfer it to the bowl. Now, we come to the best part of this recipe. Yes, the meat. It might take some time to cook, so toss the pieces regularly to avoid it from sticking to the pan. Ta-da! The chicken's ready. The japchae is almost ready. We need to mix all the ingredients together. Add some garlic, black pepper, some soy sauce and sesame oil. Garnish with roasted sesame.
Let's move on to the second part of our recipe.
We'll need sliced onions and finely chopped or pureed tomatoes. Add 1 tablespoon oil to a pan and add the onions to it. Fry on a medium flame. Now that the onions are slightly brown, add a chopped clove of garlic and sauté it. Now add green chilies and wait till the onions turn completely brown. Add some salt, turmeric powder, Kashmiri chili, Thana Jeera and Everest Kitchen King. Sauté these masalas till you get a nice aroma, but make sure that they do not burn. Now add in the tomatoes. Mix the tomatoes and onions together. As we can see, this has cooked for 2 to 3 minutes now and has started simmering. Even the color has changed. Cover the pan with a lid and pour some water over it. Reduce the flame from medium to low. The interesting thing here is that you have to cook the onion and tomato till it becomes one homogeneous mixture. Add jaggery powder and coriander. I have some seaweed strips here which I will be using. It's time to add the ubiquitous Edo. As for the egg, you can either poach them or whisk them before adding it to the top of the tomato. It's up to you. I personally prefer them whisked. While we wait for the eggs to cook, Let's prepare the dish to layer our food. Place the japchae at the bottom and pat it until it forms a solid base. I have some fried salami here, which I am going to place on top of the japchae to form a meat layer. This is going to be our final layer. Cut the egg into slices and gently place it on top of the salamis. And voila, here it is, our pretty little fusion dish.
I hope you enjoyed this as much as I did.